Let's take a look at animations. Animations are used to bring your industrial graphics to life. To start, I'll add a rectangle to my canvas and also some text to the canvas. The simplest way to open the Edit Animation window is to double-click an element that you want to animate, and the Animations window opens. There are alternative ways as well. From the Properties sheet in the bottom right is the Animations list, where you can access the animations here from this button to add another animation. And you can also right-click on the element that you want to animate and choose this Edit Animations option. And finally, there's a keyboard shortcut, Control A, for animation. Let's take a look at the animations. To add an animation, you click the plus button at the top of the Edit Animations dialog box. Animations are organized into two categories: visualization animations, which show visually to the screen so the operator can perceive them with their eyes, and the interaction animations, which receive input from the operator in the form of peripheral devices such as touchscreen, mouse, keypad, keyboard, etc. You will notice that due to the fact that we open the animation dialog box from a rectangle, some of the animations are not possible. It isn't possible, for instance, to use a text style animation where there is no text. It isn't possible to display a value when there is no text. We could contrast this effect by double-clicking on the text and notice that in this one, while text is available and value display is available, some of the things that can only be done on solid elements: fill style, line style, fill horizontal, fill vertical, are not available because text does not have those features. If, however, I group these two objects together and then double-click on the group, then additional animations are not available. By selecting an animation, it is added to the animations list. To remove an animation, you can click the Remove Animations, Confirm, and the animation is removed from the list. With an animation available from the list, you can also disable and enable the animation with this dropdown. This allows you to leave the configuration in place without losing it, while temporarily, for instance, disabling the animation. Depending on the animation selected, the options in the Details area on the right is displayed. For example, if for this visibility animation I choose the Boolean option, then I'm required to enter a Boolean reference or expression. I'm also able to decide whether it will be visible or invisible when that expression is true. When entering an expression or reference, you're able to begin typing. If you're familiar already with what's there, you can use the autocomplete to finish the example. If you want to clear an animation that's been configured, you can use the eraser button to clear the animation. If you don't remember any part of the reference you're looking for, it is easiest to use the ellipsis button on the right to browse for the reference. In the case of InTouch, there is a tab called InTouch Tag Browser, which allows you to see all the tags available from InTouch, and then locate a specific tag that you're looking for, select it, click OK. You can also add dot fields to the tag from this dot field dropdown list.